And now I simply cannot believe that a woman with such bravery loves me. How lucky I am to stand by your side and soak up even a little bit of your light. If my only purpose in life is to love a woman as great as you, then I will be a very fulfilled man indeed.
I love you.
I love you.
Your love is an unrequited fantasy. Colin sees you as you are and regards you no differently than he does Eloise.
As you consider suitable matches for Francesca, what do you hope she finds?
I wish for Francesca the same thing I wanted for myself. Passion, excitement, a love that is thrilling.
But I thought you believed the best foundation for great love was friendship.
Indeed, I do. It is how your father and I began. But it is rare to begin as friends and for both parties to then feel more.
And how did you and Father know he was reciprocating?
Because he gathered the courage to ask.
For God's sake, Penelope Featherington, are you going to marry me or not?
And until he knows the real, he cannot possibly love you.
What about my dreams?
Ladies do not have dreams. They have husbands.
Lady Whistledown is my name.
Your name is about to be Bridgerton. You cannot be both.
You are Lady Whistledown. I knew something was wrong. As if I was undeserving of your love.
I would never forgive you.
I am about to be married to the man I love, and I do not know that I am worthy of you.
Have you already forgiven her?
I want to. Do you think you can?
I think you should consider yourself uncommonly lucky. You have never been in love.
There's no such thing as true love without first embracing your true self. You do not sound as if you hate Whistledown. You sound as if you're jealous of her.
No, I'm not.
Do you know what it is like to have nowhere in the world you can truly be yourself? You cannot possibly know because you are not a woman. You have the choice to be any kind of person you wish to be, while the only choice women have is to conceal the parts of ourselves the world will not accept. I am Whistledown. I will not change that.
Ever since I found out you are Whistledown, I have done everything I can to try to separate you from her. But the other day, I went back and read all of the letters you have sent me. Your letters have always been the ones I'm most eager to read, and I realized you are her. You have always had one voice. There is no separating you from Whistledown. And after seeing you speak today, well, I would not want to.
With the retirement of my literary persona, I should like to formally introduce myself. Previous wallflower, current columnist, observer, wielder of a quill. Nobody unique, and yet I have my moments.
And hopefully, dear reader, you will stay on to enjoy them with me as we begin this next part of our journey. Yours truly, Penelope Bridgerton.